Hello and welcome to EESC 418. This week we're looking at Lecture 5, which is ways we can make our document shorter, yet more precise and to the point. And Lecture 5A is about conciseness, which is specifically about making our document short without losing information. I like to start with a quote from Blaise Pascal, because this really sums up our challenge in technical writing. How do we make our document short? And this is a paradoxical quote, because you'd think if you spent more time on something, you might make it longer. But actually, in technical writing, the longer we spend, often the shorter our writing will become. So the quote is, "I have made this letter longer than usual only because I have not had the time to make it shorter." And so he's apologizing for making it longer, because he knows that he's making people read more information than they really need to get to the point that he's trying to make. So let's get into how we can make our document shorter. First, let's talk about the concept of conciseness, also known as concision. What does this really mean? So it comes from the Latin word concisus, which means to cut short. We are going to cut our sentences short. The key here, though, is that we are going to do so without eliminating any real information. So we're going to cut redundant words, we're going to cut empty phrases, we're going to look at removing repetition, and we want to end up with a document that is short, direct, and to the point. So the concept we're looking for in technical writing is maximum information with the minimum number of words. In other words, making every word count. And before we get into these next examples, I just want to draw a distinction between conciseness and brevity. So brevity means making something short. And when we make something brief, or when we say, for the sake of brevity, we'll normally exclude some information. And the key there is that brevity will exclude information, whereas conciseness does not remove any information. So, and then completeness. We need our document to be complete enough to tell a full picture. We need to tell all about our methods, our results, our discussions. We need to discuss the data. So we need to convey all of the necessary information. And so we're going to strike a balance between trimming down our document to remove anything that's unnecessary, but leaving in any information that the reader will need in order to come to the same conclusions that we are ultimately trying to reach by the end of our document. So let's look at some ways that we can do that. First is cutting out wordy offenders. There are a lot of different words that we tend to use that we can use different words instead, which are much shorter and often more powerful. So the first category is nouns that should actually be verbs. So for the purpose of the determination of method detection limits, we can rephrase that and just say to determine method detection limits. And there's a hint here. Words that end in A-N-C-E, M-E-N-T, or T-I-O-N. So for example, rather than say for the advancement of, we would say to advance. Rather than for the completion, we would say to complete, and on and on and on. So the objective of this study was the collection of samples. We collected samples. Much more concise, we're saying pretty much the same thing. It's not exactly the same thing. And in fact, often when people say the objective of some study was to do something or other, they could easily have just said, we did this, or we did that. We can often, rather than simply just removing words, we can rephrase the sentence and give a more direct statement. This comes to the topic of weak verbs. These are similar to the passive tense, although it's not exactly the same. The instrument has the ability to report the method detection limits. The instrument reports the method detection limits. On the right, this is a stronger verb. On the left, we're using the word has as our verb. So anytime you see the word is followed by some verb phrase or has, if you can just simply use the verb or an entirely different verb to replace that whole phrase, you'll end up with a more concise sentence. Another way that we can remove a lot of text from a document without really losing any information is to remove repetition and redundancy. And these are similar concepts. Repetition is essentially a repeat of the same word or phrase or paragraph, whereas redundancy is using different words to say the same thing. So in other words, we're just giving redundant information by restating something or using multiple words when a single word really says the same thing. So let's talk about repetition. Often there will be a word that's used throughout a paragraph which can be omitted because it's implied that that is the subject of the paragraph. A bigger way that we often add a lot of text to documents, though, is in repeating entire paragraphs or sentences from one section to the next to remind the reader of what we think is an important concept. This happens a lot when people are writing about results or discussing their results. They might say, as mentioned in the methods section, we used this method or that method or measured this type of sample. In this example I'm showing, you might see somebody referring back to their objectives. So you might find this in the results or the discussion. As stated in the introduction section, the objective of this study was to identify mineral phases of the host rock. So maybe somebody had written this. My solution to this is just to delete this entirely. In other words, there is no replacement text for this. This doesn't need to be in there in the first place. If the reader has forgotten what the objective of the study is, the reader can go back and look at that themselves. We don't need to just assume that the reader's forgotten this type of information. So avoid any sort of wholesale repetition where we're going to say as stated here or as stated there, and then you completely restate what you've already said. We should just simply assume that the reader has actually read the document and that they are able to go back and look that up if they need to. Redundancy. So redundancy comes in a lot of different forms. Any particular measuring instrument will do the job. I've shortened this to just say any instrument will do. Will do the job. The job is redundant. We know that the job needs to be done. So any instrument will do is much shorter. Any particular measuring instrument, if you're seeing a bunch of words describing an instrument or describing some noun, and those words are fairly unnecessary because those are almost by definition what that noun is, you can just reduce your text by eliminating that redundancy. The next is a special type of phrasing called expletive constructions. Expletive constructions start with it is or there are. And in this case, it is and there are completely empty words. They're not even the subject of the sentence. So it is the pH probe that measures hydrogen ions. We can shorten that to say, the pH probe measures hydrogen ions. Similarly, there are six groups of soil that comprise the main classifications: sandy, silty, clayey, peaty, chalky, and loamy. We can shorten that just to say six groups of soil comprise the main classification. In almost all of these cases, when you see these expletives, something starts with it is, and then some phrase, and then that, and then another phrase that describes it. You can simply rephrase it by removing those expletives. The next category are called circumlocutions. And ironically, this is a fancy sounding word for fancy sounding phrases. Circumlocutions means to speak around in Latin. So I really like this word, actually, but that's besides the point. Here are some fancy sounding phrases that you might see in a technical report that can be either completely eliminated or replaced with a single word. So by virtue of the fact that, we can just say because, for the purpose of, we can say for, it is important to note that, we can just delete this one entirely. Again, this is a pet peeve of mine. If something is important to note that, great, note it. You don't need to tell the reader what's important. Really, if it's not important, why would it be in your report in the first place? Anyway, so it goes without saying that. Kind of the same concept, you can just delete that. For all intents and purposes, what does that really mean? Basically nothing. Owing to the fact that, just say because. There are a lot of these listed in the textbook and on the other sites that I've posted links to, so have a look at all of these and pay really close attention to these, because I can promise you that you'll see a lot of tests and quizzes and things with these phrases hidden in them, and part of the marking will definitely be to remove these types of phrases. So here's a paragraph. This one is not for marks, but I'd like you to try and reword this paragraph and see if you can make it less wordy without losing any significant information. So I'm going to give you a few seconds. I want you to pause the video and then I'll move on and I'll show you how I've rewritten it. Okay, so I've taken it down to 49 words. This is not necessarily the best way to do it. When you're rewriting a paragraph like this, there's lots of different ways you can do it. And there's no absolute magic number of how many words this should have ended up as. Probably somebody could have done it in 40 to 60 words saying more or less the same thing, and it would be fairly correct. This is not like a mathematical formula where there's only one right answer. The point here is that that paragraph could have been cut approximately in half. If you tried this and you got it down to say 60 words, you've probably done well enough. If you've gotten it down to 40 words, That's great. Just be careful that you're not then missing any essential information. So go on and do the reading. There are lots of really good examples in both textbook chapters, as well as the online writing lab. There are two pages that I've linked to. I've actually linked to four, but there are two that I really want you to pay attention to. One on concision and one on eliminating words. So please take your time with those and look at how the authors of those pages have eliminated words. Look at each example and, you know, pay attention to them and look at how they were reworded. And then I've also linked to Dr. Kim Blank's wordiness list. It's a fairly long list, but it's a very good list of lots of different phrases that can be reduced to a word or eliminated entirely. So please take your time with those. This is an extremely important topic in technical writing, and I promise you, if you can cut this type of phrase out of your writing, you'll make it much easier on your reader. Take your time with that, and we'll see you in Lecture 5B.